field that day to reap, and go thou after them. Have I not charged the young men that they do not touch thee? And when thou art thirst, go unto the vessels, and drink of that which the young men have drawn. Then she fell on her face, and bowed herself to the ground, and said unto him, Why have I found grace in thine eyes, that thou shouldst take not to me, seeing on a stranger? And Boaz answered and said unto her, It hath fully been showed me, all that thou hast done unto my mother-in-law, since the death of thy husband, and how thou hast left thy father, and thy mother, and the land of thy nativity, and are come unto a people which thou knewest not heretofore. But the Lord recompense thy work, and a full reward be given thee of the Lord God of Israel, under whose wings thou art come to trust. Then she said, Let me find favor in thy sight, my Lord, for that thou hast comforted me, and for that thou hast spoken friendly of thy handmaiden, though I be not like unto one of thy handmaidens. And Boaz said unto her, At mealtime, come thou hither, and eat the bread, and dip thy morsel in the vinegar. And she sat beside her reapers, and he reached her parched corn, and she did eat, and was suffice, and left. And when she was risen up to glean, Boaz commanded the young men, saying, Let her glean even among the sheaves, and reproach her not. And let fall also the handfuls of purpose for her, and leave them, and she may glean them, and rebuke her not.
So she gleaned in the field until even, and she beat out that she had gleaned, and is that ephah of barley. And she took it up, and went into the city, and her mother-in-law saw what she had gleaned, and she brought forth and gave to her that she had deserved after she was sufficed. And her mother-in-law said unto her, Where hast thou gleaned today, and where broughtest thou? Blessed be he that did take knowledge of thee. And she showed her mother-in-law with whom she had not, and said, The man's name with whom I wrought today is God. And Naomi said unto her daughter-in-law, Blessed be he of the Lord who hath not left off his kindness to the living and to the dead. And she said, and Naomi said unto her, The man is near kin unto us, one of our next kinsmen. And Ruth the Moabitess said, He said unto me also that I shall keep back from my young men until they have ended all my harvest. And Naomi said unto Ruth her daughter-in-law, It is good, my daughter, that thou go out with his maidens, that they meet thee not in any other field. So she kept fast by the maidens of Boaz to glean into the end of barley harvest and of wheat harvest, and dwelt with her mother-in-law.
Then Naomi, her mother-in-law, said unto her, My daughter, shall I not seek rest for thee that it may be well with thee? And is not Boaz of her kindred with whose maidens thou wast? Behold, he winnoweth barley tonight in the threshing floor. Wash thyself therefore and anoint thee, and put thy raiment upon thee, and get thee down into the floor, and make not thyself known unto the men, until they shall have done eating and drinking. And it shall be when he lieth down, that thou shalt mark the place where he lies. Thou shalt go in, and uncover his feet, and lay thee down. And tell thee what thou shalt do. And she said unto her, All that thou sayest unto me I will do. And she went down into the floor and did according to all that her mother-in-law bade her. And when Boaz had eaten and drunk, and his heart was merry, he went to lie down at the end of the heap of corn. She came in softly, and uncovered his feet, and laid her down. And when it came to pass at midnight, the man was afraid, turned himself, and behold, a woman lay at his feet. And she said unto her, Who art thou? And she answered, I am Ruth thy handmaid. Spread forth thy skirt over thine handmaid, for thou art a near kinsman.
And he said, Blessed be thou of the Lord, my daughter, for thou hast shown more kindness in the latter end than at the beginning, inasmuch as thou followest not young men, whether poor or rich. And now, my daughter, fear not, I will do to thee all that thou requirest. For all the city of my people doth know that thou art a virtuous woman. And now it is true that I am thy near kinsman. Howbeit, there is a kinsman nearer than I. Tarry this night, and it shall be in the morning, that if he will perform unto thee the part of a kinsman, well, let him do the kinsman's part. But if he will not do to thee the part of a kinsman, then I will do to thee the part of a kinsman. As the Lord liveth, lie down in the morning. And she lay at his feet until the morning. And she rose up before one could know another. And he said, Let it not be known that a woman came into the floor. Also he said, Bring the veil that thou hast upon thee and hold it. And barley gave he me, for he said to me, Go not empty unto thy mother-in-law. Then said she, Sit still, my daughter, until thou know how the matter will fall, for the man will not be in rest until he have finished the things this day.
And went Boaz up to the gate and sat him down there. And behold, the kinsman of whom Boaz spake came by, unto whom he said, Ho, such a one, turn aside and sit down here. And he turned aside and sat down. And he took 10 men of the elders of the city and said, Sit ye down here. And they sat down. Then he said unto the kinsman, Naomi, that is come again out of the country of Moab, sells a parcel of land which was our brother Elimelech. And I thought to advertise thee, saying, Buy it before the inhabitants and before the elders of my people. If thou wilt redeem it, redeem it. If thou wilt not redeem it, then tell me, that I may know. For there is none to redeem it besides thee, and I am after thee. And he said, I will redeem it. Then said Boaz, What day thou buyest the field of the hand of Naomi, thou must buy also of Ruth the Moabitess, the wife of the dead, to raise up the name of the dead upon his inheritance. And the kinsman said, I cannot redeem it for myself, lest I mar mine own inheritance. Redeem thou my right to thyself, for I cannot redeem it.
Now this was the manner in former times of Israel, concerning redeeming and concerning changing, which is concerning all things. The man put out the shoe and gave it to his neighbor. Now this was a testimony in Israel. Therefore the kinsman said unto Boaz, Buy it for thee. So he drew up his shoe. Then said Boaz unto all the elders and unto all the people, Ye are witnesses this day, that I have bought all that was Elimelech, and all that was Chilion, and the lands of the hand of Naomi. Moreover, Ruth the Moabitess, the wife of Malon, have I purchased with my wife, to raise up the name of the dead upon his inheritance, that the name of the dead be not cut off from among his brethren, and the gate of his place bear witness to this day. And all the people that were in the gate and the elders said, We are witnesses. The Lord make the woman that is coming to thine house like Rachel and like Leah, which two did build the house of Israel. And do thou worthily in Ephrathah and be famed as investment. And let thy house be like the house of Pharaoh, and Tamar bear unto Judah of the seed which the Lord shall give thee of this young woman.
So Boaz took Ruth, and she was his wife, and when he went in unto her, the Lord gave her conception, and she bare a son. And the woman said unto Naomi, Blessed be the Lord, which hath not lost thee this day, but thou a kinsman, that his name may be famous in Israel. And he shall be unto thee a restorer of thy life, and a nourisher of thine old age. For thy daughter-in-law loveth thee, which is better to thee than seven sons hath borne him. And Naomi took the child and laid it in her bosom and became nurse unto it. And the one of her neighbors gave it a name, saying, There is a son born to Naomi. And they called his name Obed. He is the father of Jesse, the father of David.
Now these are the